Rub-ons, paper, and washi, oh my. When I first saw 49 and Market's new Vintage Artistry Nature Study Collection, I was blown away. With soft forest-themed colors, it's easy to imagine yourself surrounded by the flora and fauna in a forest or out in a meadow someplace. My samples arrived less than 24 hours ago, and I could not wait to create with them. I've only done a couple of things that I'm going to show you now as I move through this really quick video. So this is a journal that you'll see in the coming weeks, but the inside front cover was covered with a piece of paper from the Colored Foundations pack. I added rub-ons from the Sentiments and Color Study 12x12 rub-on collections. So here's the paper. These are rub-ons. This is a rub-on. This big piece is a rub-on. And did you know that you can put rub-ons on top of rub-ons? That's how I got this really fun look, all of this kind of layered stuff. I added one piece, and I'm going to show you a little bit more about this in a second, of the double pocket from the Essential File Set. And then I finished it with butterflies. This is from the laser cut, what is this called, Winged Elements set. So that's what these three pieces are here. Now this is just a little piece of paper. So obviously when I cut the backing for this, I had a piece left over. So this is just a 4x6 piece of paper that I cut from that leftover, and I used some more of the rub-ons from that Color Study 12x12 collection. Actually, you know what, I think that it was a different one. We'll get to that in a second. Now, I'm not convinced this is done. I might want to put a butterfly here. But I like that this is a little bit more spare. There's not as much stuff going on, and I think it's a great complement to this. Okay, so let me take you through the products that I used. And I'm going to start, let's turn this way. I'm going to start with, this is half of the, what is this thing called? Oh, good grief. This thing is called the Double Pocket. So this is a different collection, but you can see that this is what it looks like. It comes built like this. And I simply, let me move this out of the way. I simply cut this piece off and put it on the page using some sticky stuff. So super easy to do. You can use it full size the way that it is, or you can cut it up and use smaller pieces. So this is the Essentials File Collection. This is the winged elements, Nature Study Winged Elements. I'm reading upside down. These are all laser cut, so they pop out of here. And you can see that there's a variety of sizes. This is the, I can't read upside down. This is the Colored Foundations Collection Pack. And, well, you can't see anything there. But this is the piece that I used on the inside of the front cover. And now we get into the rub-ons. And I have to tell you, I haven't always been a fan of rub-ons, but 49 and Market is definitely teaching me to be one. So this is the, again, I'm trying to read upside down. This is the Sentiments rub-on, and this is that piece that I used on the inside front cover. This is another piece that I used. So again, if I bring this back, I used Observe and not Curious. So here is the Observe, and this is the background piece that came from here, and then I just put Explore over the top of it. I thought, well, can I put rub-ons on top of rub-ons? And as it turns out, you absolutely can. And then, where am I? I didn't use any of the smaller rub-ons, so this is everything that I used to create this. And let's move now into some of the other stuff. Since I'm fascinated with rub-ons and washi, I'm going to start there. So this is the postage washi, and 49 and Market has been putting out this postage style washi for ages now in all of their collections. And then these are the new washi stickers. There's a couple of different sets included here. Rub-ons. Oh my goodness, rub-ons. I'm not even going to try to read the name because, again, I'm doing this upside down. Oh, you know what? I can read it on the monitor. So this is the wings. Let's throw that over there. Well, the glare doesn't help, does it? This is foliage. This is mushrooms. Oh, mushrooms, mushrooms. We all love mushrooms. They've become so popular. So this, again, the glare is brutal here. This is the, this is not named anything. Well, nevertheless, here it is. And underneath here, that's all of the large ones. I've already shown you the others. There's a couple of 6x8 paper packs because they, meaning 49 and Market, always create papers in 12x12 and 6x8. These are really pretty. And then here are the 12 by 12 collections. So this is, I thought initially I was going to use this on the backgrounds, and then I ended up going with the more subtle one that I showed you, and then ledgers. Ledgers have become really popular since probably Diane Reeveley started to display her journals created out of old ledgers ages ago, several, 5, 6, 8, 9 years ago. So I'm really happy to see these. And what else do we have here? We have spiral bound notebook set. There's a couple in here. There are these awesome, let's turn this over, film strip frames. And then we have some other odd bits here someplace, or I thought we did. Maybe that's the end of it. I've kind of lost track. Oh, no, here it is. I buried them. I knew there was more. So laser cut stuff. This is acetate sentiment shapes, an ephemera pack, and let's look and see what's inside there, all kinds of stuff. And there's a chipboard word set for those of you who like to include these kind of things. And then there's just another chipboard set that has all these fun elements. So Nature Study is a wonderful collection. I'm just trying to figure out what I did with my journal. It got thrown in a corner here. And I think you're going to enjoy creating with it. This is not the last of it you'll see from me. I have plans for this collection. So Nature Study, now in stock and shipping from joggles.com.